greetings. I recently had a Muslim post a short, cryptic extract from Scripture, or as if it came from Scripture. I had blocked him years ago, but recently culled my list of blocked Muslims. And there he was, watching a recent video and posting. But God's word is like good seed. It cannot be corrupted, and it will return to God after accomplishing God's purpose. Isaiah 55:11, "So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it." So I'm happy he is still watching videos. And may the Lord Jesus open his eyes to the truth. So the Muslim posted the following. Isaiah 42:12, Islamic Conquest. "Let them, Kedar, give glory to the Lord and declare his praise in the coastlands. The Lord shall go forth like a mighty man. He shall stir up his zeal like a man of war." Sure enough, the book of Isaiah does have a 42nd chapter. And that chapter does have a 12th verse. It just looks nothing at all like what this Mohammedan posted. Rule number one. Never, never, ever, ever believe what a Muslim says the Bible says. But there is an old sage, never ascribe malice where simple stupidity or ignorance is a sufficient excuse. Muslims are often very sincere and tragically deceived. Isaiah 42:12, Islamic Conquest. I put it in bold. "Let them, Kedar, give glory to the Lord and declare his praise in the coastlands. The Lord shall go forth like a mighty man. He shall stir up his zeal like a man of war." The first problem is, this Muslim has been tricked to think this refers to Islamic conquest. That Isaiah 42 speaks of Mohammed. The Islamic rape of Isaiah 42 is one of the biggest blasphemies Satan's religion commits. But that is another video. Let's get back to this isolated passage. Isaiah 42 is filled with references to Lord, capital L-O-R-D, meaning Jehovah, the Tetragrammaton. Isaiah 42:5, 42:6, 42:8, 42:10, 42:12, 42:13, 19, 21, 24. Did that sound like Dr. Nike? This includes a most direct and on-point statement by Jehovah God himself. Isaiah 42:8, "I am Jehovah, that is my name. I will not yield my glory to another or my praise to idols." Out of respect for God's name, Jehovah is translated the Lord. But God's name is Jehovah, Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, in any language, in every language. So wherever the word Lord is in all caps, that means Jehovah, and disproves his name is Allah. Now, at this point, I was going to begin dissecting the Muslim invention, but I think it more appropriate to teach the true word first. Isaiah 42:8, "I am the Lord, Jehovah, that is my name. I will not yield my glory to another or my praise to idols. Behold, the former things have happened, and now I declare new things. Before they spring forth, I proclaim them to you." The God of the Bible reveals the future before it happens. The author of the Quran? Not so much. "Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise from the ends of the earth. You who go down to the sea and all that is in it, you islands and all who dwell in them." So here is the context, singing praise to Jehovah, the Lord. "Let the desert and its cities raise their voices." are they raising their voices in hate chants?
Death to Israel! Death to America!
No. From the context, they are singing loudly praise to Jehovah the Lord. Let the villages of Kedar cry aloud. Here, Kedar is mentioned. The word Kedar is actually used. But this is Isaiah 42:11, not 42:12. And what's the context? Sing to the Lord a new song, you who go down to the sea, all that is in it, the sea, fishies, you islands and all who dwell in them, cities in the desert, even villages in currently pagan Islamic Kedar. Let the desert and its cities raise their voices. Let the villages of Kedar cry aloud. Let the people of Selah sing for joy. Let them cry out from the mountaintops. At some point, the cities of the desert, the villages of Kedar, and the people of Selah will worship and praise Jehovah God. There will be such rejoicing when these people are set free from the evil of Islam to praise Jehovah God. Let the desert and its cities raise their voices. Let the villages of Kedar cry aloud. This is the only mention or usage of the word Kedar in all of Isaiah 42. Let them give glory to the Lord. Again, this is Jehovah. And declare his praise in the islands. Who is them? Let them give glory. Who is them? Cities in the desert? Villages in Kedar? The people of Selah? The people in the islands? All of those nouns are the antecedents to this pronoun. They all apply. This verse, this prophecy, foretells the destruction of Islam and the freedom to praise Jehovah with loud voices. The Lord, Jehovah, goes forth like a mighty one. He stirs up his zeal like a warrior. He shouts, and yes, he roars in triumph over his enemies. Again, notice the Lord is Jehovah, the name of the one true living God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And all the pronouns are capitalized. He, his, God's preferred male pronouns. Let me remind you of the original post by the Muslim. It attempts to represent the text of scripture we just read. Islamic conquest. Let them, Kedar, give glory to the Lord and declare his praise in the coastlands. The Lord shall go forth like a mighty man. He shall stir up his zeal like a man of war. We shall see this is an invention that has a cursory resemblance, but critically changes certain details of significance. We've read from Isaiah. Now let's do a side-by-side comparison. It will be smaller text, but you'll get the picture. Here are the full texts, side by side. Let's remove this Islamic conquest comment. Let's highlight the actual text of Isaiah 42:12 below. So the first corruption of Scripture is this attempted insertion of Kedar. It appears, but only in verse 11. The parentheses appear to be an attempted translator insertion, as if there were scholarly merit to make this clarification. This is really an attempt to force the interpretation Mohammedism requires. The actual context and an appropriate clarification would be the desert cities, the villages of Kedar, and the people of Selah. Let's consider the next section of text without including the editorial edition, Kedar. This section in red on the left actually does come from 42:12. We can see that below. But notice the subtle deletion of the name of God, Lord, not Lord in all caps. With only L capitalized, Lord implies master, leader, owner, and fits an intended insertion of Mohammed. Typically, non-Christian, non-English speakers do not know the capitalization rules. So they do not know Lord in all capital letters always means Jehovah. But in general, Islam's blasphemous rape of Isaiah 42 is to give God's glory to Mohammed. Let's look at the next section of text, which the original Muslim poster includes as part of Isaiah 42:12. There it is in red. This section in red on the left actually comes from 42 verse 13, but only the first half. Again, notice the subtle deletion of the name of God, using El and the rest of Lord in lowercase, not Lord all in uppercase. The first half is used, along with claims Muhammad was a warrior, to create an imagined link to Muhammad, because he led armies, raided caravans, and waged jihads. But Islam appears unable to find or create a plausible twisting of the second half. Evidently, Muhammad did not shout, or there are no fables of Muhammad shouting over his enemies. So that is the passage the Muslim invented to present as evidence of Islamic conquest, dominance, and credentials for Muhammad from Prophet Isaiah. If you are Muslim, I have a challenge for you, brother. Why would a Muslim take scripture, God's message from Al-Katib, and change it? Why take the message of the prophets and change it to glorify Muhammad? Why take scripture that glorifies God, your creator, and redirect your worship to Muhammad? You may not like the word Mohammedism, but any religion that teaches you, trains you, and convinces you to do such things to advance your religion has not so subtly programmed you that Muhammad is above God, above the Allah you think you obey. We see multiple changes to the message of Prophet Isaiah, including appropriation, theft of God's glory to deify the man Muhammad. That could be simple ignorance, a calloused disregard for the message of Al-Katib that the Quran says is equal to the Quran. Or such invention by Muslims could be damning evidence against the Islam that drives them like obedient cattle. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And may He deliver you from the evil of Islam. Amen.